very good morning to one and all present here. Before I start with my speech, I want everybody in this auditorium to stand up, including the judges. Yes. Ready? Now that you've stood up, now I want everybody to shout that you are awesome. Believe that you're awesome and shout it out. Tell that you're awesome. Awesome. Believe that you're awesome and shout it out. Okay, let's do it another time. 1, 2, 3. I'm awesome. And also say that you're not a survivor anymore. Say that you're a conqueror. Let's do it another time. 1, 2, 3. I'm not a survivor. I'm a conqueror. Let's do it another time. I'm not a survivor. I'm a conqueror. Great. Please take your seats. So, you people might be wondering why I asked you to scream out, to shout that you're awesome. Because most of the time, in the run of life, we forget how an amazing and a phenomenal creature we are. A phenomenal creature ultimately leads a phenomenal life. But we always complain that life is complicated. We say life is complex. So this is Ashwini Govindaraju. I'm going to break it down for you and tell life is not complex. Life is actually very simple. I'm going to tell you life is not about just surviving it. It is all about conquering it. So when you want to conquer something in life, you understand how it works. You understand every minute details of it, and then you go out to conquer it. So I'm here to tell you how to conquer life. Talking about conquering life, there is one thing that I think is lacking in current generation. We don't set goals in life. So talking about goals, I would like to quote this one quote that I totally disagree. It goes this way. Aim for the moon. If you miss, you will reach to the stars. If you've actually aimed for the moon, you will work over and over and over until you reach to the moon. You will not get satisfied with something that you get in life. Talking about this, I would like to quote an example of a real life story that completely changed me and can change your lives too. So there was this young man in 1936 in Hungary. His only aim in life is to get a gold medal in Olympics in the pistol shooting event. His name was Carolyn. He worked so hard. He emerged as one of the world-class pistol shooter that Hungary has ever seen. And he was practicing so hard for the 1940 Olympics. But unfortunately, when he was in a training camp in 1938, when he was about to throw a hand grenade from his right hand, it explodes in his right pistol shooting hand. Devastated becomes Carolyn. Carolyn spends the next 1 month in hospital feeling depressed about the losses that had happened in his life. The Olympic dream had come to an end. His world-class pistol shooting that he had lost. And a year passed by. In 1939, there is a Hungarian national level pistol shooting competition that's happening. Carolyn goes up to the event and is congratulating every single participant, and the participants are so happy. Man, see his sportsmanship. But Carolyn puts up a smile and says, "My dear friends, I'm not here to encourage you. I'm here to compete." Yes, Carolyn had done an unimaginable thing. He had trained himself to shoot with his left hand. Carolyn did not cry about something that he had lost in his life. In fact, he worked on something that he had, an unimaginable mental toughness that he had, and also a left hand. He did it in secret because he did not want people to discourage him. Carolyn goes up to the pedestal. He takes up the gun in his left hand, aims at the bullseye. Yes, who do you think would have emerged as a winner? Carolyn. Yes, Carolyn bagged the gold medal in the national pistol shooting event of Hungary. But that didn't satisfy Carolyn. As I told you, what was Carolyn's dream or goal in life? He wanted to get a gold medal in Olympics. He did not get satisfied with stars that he got. He aimed for the moon. So Carolyn worked so hard for the 1940 Olympics. But 1940 Olympic was called off at the last moment because of World War II. Carolyn again gets depressed, but he doesn't stop. He practices for another 4 years, works so hard. And 1944 Olympics also gets cancelled because of World War II. By this time, people started losing hope on Carolyn. They thought Carolyn was old. At this time, Carolyn has already become 38 years of age. Young players have come into the field. New techniques have come. His techniques have become old, outdated. But that didn't stop Carolyn. Carolyn worked so hard, and in 1948 Olympics, people are literally laughing at Carolyn. Carolyn goes to the event, takes up the pistol in his left hand, aims at the bullseye. What happened? Carolyn won the gold medal. He not only did win a gold medal, he created a world record. Yes, he goes back, trains himself for the next 4 years and also gets a gold medal in 1952 pistol shooting Olympics. So my dear friends, when you set a goal, you will have to be so determined until and unless you reach to that goal. So say it with me. When you reach for the moon, you'll work hard until you reach to the moon. Tell it with me. Aim for the moon. I will walk over and over again until I reach to the moon. So now that you've set goals in life, do you just set goals and look at it? Oh yeah, I've set a goal. Yes, it's there. No, you walk every single moment towards your goal. Here I would like to tell, Arnold was once asked, what was the secret behind his success? He said, when I decided to become a bodybuilding champion, I did not want to become another normal bodybuilding champion. I wanted to become the greatest and the most praised bodybuilding champion of all time. When I decided to become a Hollywood star, I did not want to become another Hollywood star. I wanted to become the highest paid Hollywood star of all time. And you know what? Arnold faced lots and lots of criticism at his initial stage of career. He was told on face that you're nothing but a giant muscle. He was told on face that you have an accent that's laughable. But that didn't stop Arnold. He worked on something that he was so strong. And we know how successfully he emerged in his life. So my dear friend, when you decided to waste your time, when you decided to party around with your friend, there is somebody out there who is becoming successful. There is somebody out there who is moving an inch closer to their dreams. So to be successful in life, there is no way around. Hard, hard work. So we have talked about setting up goals. We have talked about to work towards a goal. Next thing that we should practice is ignoring the naysayers. A quick quiz. Who was a Paralympian who fetched a gold medal in 2016 Rio Olympics in the field of high jump? Great that you know his name, Thangavelu Mariappan. Do you know what? Before 2016 Rio Olympics, he was also qualified before that itself for the 2012 London Olympics. But he couldn't make it to the Olympic event because he did not have a passport at the last moment. Not that he did not have talent. In fact, if he had participated in 2012 London Olympics, he would have got a gold because Mariappan's record at that point of time was 1.75, wherein the person who fetched gold medal in London Olympics was 1.74. He wasn't able to go because he did not have passport. You know what? Entire village thought he wasn't capable of going because he did not have one of the legs. People did not know Paralympics was an event that was happening for handicapped people. In fact, for differently able people, I cannot put handicap, I would say differently able people. But people thought, yeah, people completely humiliated him for the next 4 years. So when he was about to go for the 2016 Olympics, he did not even tell his mother that he was going a Paralympics event because he wanted to prove the world and then scream out his success. So ignore the naysayers. You're going to meet them in every single turn that you take in life. They're going to tell you cannot do this. They will tell you this is going to be tough. Don't do this. Ignore the naysayers because when you do achieve success, people are going to tell you trendsetters. People are going to tell you change makers. So ignore the naysayers. And finally, don't be afraid to fail. When you fall 899 times, you get back up 900 times. When talking about failures, I can quote myself as an example. I wasn't the same Ashwini who I am today. 2 years exactly back, I was into depression. I lost hope. Life absolutely pulled me so down. I had no spark left in me. But that night when my depression was at its peak, my life could have taken two adverse turns. One line of Bharatiyar completely changed my life forever.
கொடுங்கூற்றுக்கிற என பின் மாயும் பல வேடிக்கை மனிதரை போல நான் வீழ்வேன் என்று நினைத்தாயோ? Did you think that I will fall like every normal person? No, I did bounce back. I bounced back with utmost energy and with just one motive in life. The Ashwini who I actually wanted to be, the Ashwini who would spread positivity and happiness to people around me, that I am doing today. This is Ashwini Govindaraju to you, my dear friend. So what is stopping you from becoming successful in life? If a man who lost his right hand can become an Olympic medalist, if a person who is completely pushed down in life can come and talk in front of you, what is stopping you from becoming a successful person in life? So with this thought, I would leave you with one quote that will leave you inspired forever. From my inspiration, Superwoman, it goes this way. The hardest thing you will ever fight for in your life is the fight for your own happiness. But that is the only thing worth fighting for. This is Ashwini Govindaraju signing off.
You didn't quote anybody.
I did.
You quoted yourself. That is what it is. It is inspiring. It is very good. Please keep it up.
Thank you, sir. Hi, Ashwini.
Hello, ma'am.
Thank you for taking us through a very inspiring journey of goal setting and happiness.
Thank you, ma'am.
My question for you is, define luck.
I personally don't believe in luck. Because when you set a goal and you work towards it, you don't have to believe in luck. You give your fullest, you don't need luck by your side. I don't believe in that.
Ashwini, it was inspiring. Okay, so one question to you. So when you are chasing a goal or a dream, right, what is the cost of it to people around you? When you made a statement, when you aim for the moon, land only in the moon, nothing less than that. Yeah, that's very idealistic, agree, right? But each individual comes with, now when you say individual, you're not an individual, at least in the Indian society. You have your family, you have your lot of other responsibilities towards them are there, right? When you are pursuing that, your goal, at what cost would you still pursue till you reach the moon and not settle for the one what you said?
Yes, sir. So all these people I quoted as example, they were all normal people. But when they decided, life put a challenge in front of them, they decided to take it up and go high further. So I would like to tell that, of course, we are going to have setbacks, people are going to laugh at you, you will have your own family members. But even for example, Mariappan, his own dad asked him not to use his initial. So you said at what cost it comes. So Mariappan, when he failed to go for London Olympics, his own dad said, don't use my initial. But then he went on to get a gold medal in Rio Olympics with the chest number written as Thangavelu, his dad's name. So I personally feel you will have setbacks, but when you do achieve success, the amount of happiness and the satisfaction you get in life is worth that pain.
I think you didn't get what I said. I mean, I think you...
At what cost?
Exactly, right? So assume, I'll give you a scenario. There is a person from a whatever class he belongs to, right? You're talking about a social problem.
Yes.
It's a family problem where somebody didn't want his son to use his initial, right?
Yes.
But assuming there are a lot of other priorities in life, right? There are a lot of other commitments for an individual. I wanted to pursue this, but how do I balance it with the other priorities in life? That was my question.
Convince them about how important that thing, achieving that thing is very important to you. Convince them. If they're not convinced, it's okay. They're not convinced. Achieve it and tell it to them.
Okay. Thank you.
Are you convinced, sir? Actually,
no, he's not convinced.
Yeah. If not, I would like to better explain.
No, the what if the family pays for his success?
Sir, for example, I myself had a lot of setbacks. My dad didn't want me to become a public speaker. He didn't want me to go on stage and people looking at me. He was not fine with it. But I went on to tell him, Dad, I love doing this. I want to do this.
It is not about doing. What if your dad has to pay back, for what
me.
The mistakes which you do?
Why should he pay back for the mistake?
Yeah, for example, if you talk about somebody here and somebody sues you, right?
Okay.
Say for about 1 crore or 15 crores.
Okay.
Right? You can't pay back.
Yes.
Naturally, your dad has to attach his properties to save you.
Okay. As far as my dad is concerned, he led it to me. He said, you did this, you take care of yourself.
That is all okay now, but he's not definitely going to leave with his daughter.
So my thought motto was to inspire everybody to take up ownership.
We didn't discuss about your thought process. I'm asking, in this scenario, what will you do? Is it right or wrong? That's what we wanted to understand.
Sir, I don't think you'll have to pay a lot in order to get your dreams done. A lot of people will get sufficed with something that's happening, that they get.
So, your question is this way, right? What if I'm going towards my goal and what if my family members had to pay back?
Your dad has paid 15 crores.
Okay.
Is it good or bad? One simple answer.
I've been paid
what?
Your dad has paid 15 crores for your mistake.
Okay.
Right?
It's bad.
Thank you.